guys, welcome back. And as we know that we are learning tenses in this series of videos, so we have already understood simple present tense, present continuous tense, present perfect tense. And now today we are going to learn present perfect continuous tense. So if you haven't checked out the videos yet, please go and watch that videos. And today topic is present perfect continuous tense. Now, as you can see the name itself, it is present perfect continuous tense. So we know that we have studied perfect tense as well as continuous tense. So this tense is basically a mixture, or we can say a combination of those two tenses. See, the present perfect continuous is used for an action which began at some time in the past, but that work is still continuing. That means the work is still going on. So we use present perfect continuous tense as subject plus has or have been plus verb with ing form. As you must have remembered that in discussion of present continuous tense, I have told that ing form is showing the continuity of any work or any task. So whenever there is a continuity in the work, we use ing form of a verb, and the perfect of this tense will be shown by have or has been. Now, when the subject is I, you, we, and they, we use have with them. And if the subjects are like he, she, it, or singulars, we use has with them. Now, let us see a few examples where we can use present perfect continuous. So, the very first example here is, he has been sleeping for 5 hours. See, the function or the operation, or we can say action, is already started, and he is still sleeping. So we can see that the action began at some time in the past and it is still continuing. So we have used has been here, has, because we have used he as a subject. Now, other one is, I have been waiting to see the doctor for 2 hours. Now, what this example indicates, 2 hours have now passed and she is still waiting. That means action is still continuing. So we have used have been here. And you can see the ing form of verb as well. See, this ing form is representing the continuity of the action. One more example. I have been waiting since 5 p.m. So this example says like, see, since is representing that I have been waiting since when it was 5, but I am still waiting for the same thing. So in all the examples we see that action began in the past and is still in a continuing process. So we use a present perfect continuous tense for such examples. Now see, here I want to tell you one very important thing, and generally we do mistake here. See, for and since, when we use for and when we should use a since. For is actually used to tell the amount of time, like for 2 hours, for 5 hours. So basically for is used for amount of time. But since is used to mention the starting point of the action. That means when we have started the work. As I have just discussed an example that I have been waiting since 5 p.m. That means she started waiting at 5 p.m. and she is still waiting. Let us see a few examples of it. It has been raining all morning. Or I can say it has been raining since 4 a.m. That means rain actually started at 4 a.m. Now, all morning, it's a phrase. And in phrases like all morning, all day, we don't use a for. Actually, all morning is itself representing an amount of time. So, there's no need to use a for. If we use for with such phrases, sentence becomes superfluous and that is not correct. So, such sentences, such phrases, we don't use a for. So, whenever we mention the amount of time we use for, like, I am waiting to see the doctor for 2 hours. So, whenever we mention the amount of time or the starting point, we must use the present perfect continuous tense. Now, here, let's see. Continuous plus time expression is equal to perfect continuous. Yes, exactly. Actually, time expression implies the duration of an action. Words like since, for, whole, all, and throughout, etc. actually shows the time expression. So, I can say that this tense basically implies the duration of an action. That is from past to present. And for is used for a period of time from past to present, whereas since is used for a particular point of time or some event in past to present. Here, I want to mention one more thing. Please don't get confused between time expression and point of time. Both are quite different from each other. Here, I have discussed time expression. When we will study simple past tense, I will also tell you the difference between the time expression and point of time. Point of time actually shows when did the action taken place. So it is related to when. And time expression actually tells us the duration, and generally we people do mistake. So this thing is to be noticed that we should not get confused between point of time and time expression. In actually, when we use point of time with present perfect tense, it actually becomes simple past. So we will discuss point of time in simple past also. So today this is it for present perfect continuous tense. In next video we are going to discuss simple past tense. Till then, keep watching, keep learning. Thank you.